Okay. And so today's class is outlier detection using unsupervised learning technique. Hopefully you can see the screen. Okay. So we talk about outlier. What is outlier? As you can see from the last day's class, and here one example, the point here, the point O1 is located in the isolated region. Isolated region is in that around there is no points you can see. So, and this point we can say is quite different from the rest of the data points. So rest of the data point is they are forming a clusters here, you can see. So therefore, this point one will be considered as a outlier. So that is we talk in the last class. Okay, and then application of outlier in different area, that is fraud detection, intrusion detection, sensor network analysis, text analysis. Text analysis, let's say maybe some suspicious information if you get in a document, okay, in a set of document or in set of a news, then that can be treated as outlier. Okay, so there are three major techniques in outlier detection. One is supervised technique. As you know that supervised technique needs the training data. So training data contains the level instances for normal point as well as the outlier classes. As we defined, the outlier is a set of points which differ from the rest of the points. Rest of the points is like majority of the points follow the rule. These outlier points, they do not follow that same pattern. So therefore, as you understand, these supervised techniques will be very much imbalanced problem. It will face the imbalance problem. So another categories of technique is called semi-supervised, where you'll have only the training data for the normal points, but not required for the abnormal points or outlier points. And then end is so unsupervised techniques. That unsupervised technique do not require the training data, does not require the training data. Why? Training data, that is in general, actually getting training data for the normal and abnormal point is really difficult. As I said, the outlier points are very rare in a data set. So to avoid this set of problem, one can use the unsupervised techniques. As I said in the last this class also, unsupervised techniques are quite unsupervised techniques are quite. Yeah, someone is recording. Is it okay? How do I share that? Can I download that recording?
Yes.
Will it be visible to me?
Yes, sir, it will be visible to everyone.
Okay.
That will be saved in Teams.
Okay. So then no issue. Yeah. So this is unsupervised techniques, as I said, and then this is quite famous. So today we'll look into some unsupervised technique. We started with LOF, but I have a doubt that all of you understood or not very clearly. So let us spend some time to understand the LOF technique. LOF is quite famous. It was introduced in 2000. Okay. There are first techniques. I said NOOR techniques introduced in 1998. That is distance-based. So this algorithm is something like that. As in last class, we talk about that. Points will be called or said outlier if it away from a certain percentage of the points. Okay, it's away from the certain percentage. So let's say 80% points will be away from this particular point. So that is something called the distance-based outlier. And this threshold distance, how long it will be away, so that is decided by a threshold, and very oftenly it is taking that kth nearest neighbor distance. Okay, but it has also different problem because it may happen that k value you have taken the 4 or 5. 4 points may be very close to each other, and then 5th nearest neighbor is quite far away. So in that case, what will happen? That point will be treated as an outlier. Because if you are taking only the kth distance, you are giving much importance to the kth point, while you these algorithms are very sensitive for choosing value of k. Let's say in original data set, actually nearest neighbor should be or must be decided on the value of k is 10. But you have chosen the value of k is, let's say, 11. So it may happen the 11th point is quite far away, and that point will be treated, normal point will be treated as outlier. Okay. So to address this distance mass issue, 2000 that Brewing introduced algorithm, that is LOF. I showed you the paper in the last class. Okay. So I'll share that paper along with this slide and then video. So we'll talk about now that is Brewing work, and then we'll talk about 2009, that is quite similar as the LOF work, so that is LDOF, and then we'll talk about symmetric neighborhood, that is in 2006, yeah, ranking outlier using symmetric neighborhood relationship. So this work also we'll talk. Okay. Now we'll talk about LOF. So LOF, that is local outlier factor, computes the neighborhood density of each object in the data set. Okay. LOF score of an object is the ratio of average local density of the k nearest neighbor of the object and the local density of the object itself. LOF, to compute the LOF, that is local outlier factor, this basically specifies the outlierness of an object. So it is the ratio of the two values. One is the average local density of the k nearest neighbor. Okay. So that is local density of the k nearest neighbor and divided by, say, local density of the object for which we want to find whether the point is outlier or not. So to understand that, so we need to understand what is k dist of an object. Okay. So for any positive integer k, the k distance of the particular point p is defined as the distance between p and object p. So here let us first understand whatever definition is okay, but now we try to understand what is k dist. So now we consider the k dist of a point. Okay, let's say we are considering the k dist of a point p1 with respect to point o. So when we are talking about k dist, it should be with respect to some other point. Okay. So now if the what is the k dist of the point p1 with respect to the point o? So what you have to do first, the you have to compute the k nearest neighbor of the point o. Okay. So once you compute the k nearest neighbor, you compute the k dist of the point o. Okay. So what is the k dist distance? That is k distance is called the k. Yes, yes. So suppose we are, say, let's say here we have a, we have to compute the k dist of point P or reach dist of point P, that is the is defined as the distance from P to O and between P and O. Okay, leave it this part. Okay, what I am saying, you just listen it. So okay, so k dist is nothing but the kth distance of an object O. Okay, now based on the kth distance, so based on the kth distance, so you leave it here. Okay, so So now what we want to know, we want to know what is k-dist of an object. Okay, so k-dist distance of an object is nothing but the distance, kth distance of an object. Now knowing this one, we will define what is reach dist. Whenever we talk about reach dist, so we have to reachability distance with respect to some points. Let's say we want to compute the reach dist of a point P1 with respect to O. Then what we have to do? We have to compute the k dist of the point O, that is kth nearest neighbor point. Kth nearest neighbor point distance is of the point O. And now see, so therefore what you have to do, you have to compute from the O to P1 and kth dist distance. So which one will be the maximum? So that will be the kth dist. So in other way around, so if any point within the periphery of that, so that point's reach dist will be the kth distance. But if point is outside this one, say for this one, what will be the k dist with what will be the reach dist with respect to the point O will be the maximum of k dist and the distance from the point O to the outside point. So that therefore reach dist of point P2, where is the point P2, so with respect to O, what will be the distance? So you take the distance from this point to this point, and you take the k dist of the point O, whichever is the maximum. So that is something called reach dist. Okay. Is it okay?
So what is the k dist?
K distance. K distance is the kth distance from the point to the kth neighbor.
Okay.
So that is something called k distance. And then what is reach distance? Reach distance means reachability from the point O. So what is the reachability of point O to P1 is not only the distance this one. So if this point belong within the periphery of the k nearest neighbor, then you take the k nearest neighbor distance. But if the point is outside the k nearest neighbor distance, so then you have to take the exact distance. So therefore maximum of these two distance is something called reach dist. So if there any point within the k nearest neighbor, then if you compute the reach dist of the point with respect to the centered point, so that will be the k nearest neighbor distance. Okay, k nearest neighbor distance. Otherwise, if it is outside for this, it will be the exact distance, and point within this one, or any point within this one will be the k distance. Okay. So having said that, so here we have, that is reachability distance of an object with respect to other object O, that is reach dist of the object O with reach dist of point P with respect to O is maximum of k dist of O and the distance from P to O. That is I said earlier. So here. So if you take for any point from here, what you do it, you compute the distance from the point O to P2, and you compute the k dist of the point. K dist is nothing but the kth distance of the point O, and you take the maximum of this. So what happened it exactly? So if the point within the say periphery of the point O, so then in that those points it will be the kth distance, and if it is outside, so it will be the exact distance. So therefore here reach dist is coming, that maximum of the k distance and distance exactly the distance from P to O. So k dist is defined here of an object O can be defined as the kth nearest neighbor distance of the object O, where k is a positive integer. Okay, so this is defined k dist, and this is reachability distance. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to find the local reachability density. So density, I think I told earlier class, density is nothing but how do you define density. So physics, we define density equal to d equal to m by v, right? Mass per unit volume. So here also what you do it, we'll count the number of points within unit volume. So instead of that, what we do it, we fix it the volume. So radius, we fix it, and you count only the number of points. So therefore, whenever we consider the density, so we should compute the number of points. So now the local reachability density of an object, what is that? So it is 1 by, what is that? Reach dist of point P with respect to O. That means whenever we want to compute the LRD of a point P, what we do it? First we compute the k nearest neighbor of the points P. So that is nothing but the all point n is nothing but the k nearest neighbor of the point P. And then what we do it? For each point within the k nearest neighbor, we compute a reach dist. Okay. And then we take the sum of the all reach distance point and then divide it by the minimum number of points. As we know, there is a relation between inverse relation between density and the distance. So therefore, we have to take the inverse. Okay. Is it okay? Did you understand this? What is the, see, density is number of points. D equal to m by d. M is here nothing but the number of points. Okay. So what we are here, we are what instead of number of points, what we are considering? We are considering the distance. Okay. So therefore, an average distance. That means if you go back for any set of points, what we are considering, okay, just a minute here. So I am sharing some other article here. Yeah. So what you can see here, now what we are defining, that is local reachability density. In order to compute the local reachability density, is we are comparing here. Local reachability density, what we are doing it, we are computing the reach dist of the point P with respect to O. Now let's say we want to compute the these points local reachability density, then what you do, first task is you compute its nearest neighbor. So what is the nearest neighbor of this point? So this is the nearest neighbor, this is nearest neighbor, this is nearest neighbor, so three nearest neighbor. Now you go to the formula here. What is that? So here. So what you do it? First you compute the nearest neighbor of the point. And for each point, you compute the reach dist with respect to the point O. That means for each point, say for each point, you compute the reach dist with respect to the neighbor. So now in this figure, what you do it, say this point we are considering, first we got the nearest neighbor of the point P. So this point, this point, this point. Now what you have to do for this point, you have to compute the reach distance with respect to this point. Okay. So now how do you compute reach dist? So first you have to find the nearest neighbor of this point. You have to find the nearest neighbor of this point. You have to find nearest neighbor of this point. Can you see the slide? Sorry, can you see the paper? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Now it is okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so 2 plus 1, 2 by 1. So, yes. So, here P is the point. What we want to do? We want to compute LRD, local reachability density. So, what is the first task? You have to compute the nearest neighbor of this point. So, here nearest neighbor minimum point is 3. So this is one point, this is one point, this is another point. Okay. Now what is that? You have to compute reach disk of point P with respect to these neighbors. So to compute reach disk, how do you do it? You have to compute the nearest neighbor of this point. So nearest neighbor of this point is 1, 2, 3. So this point. Okay. So then what is the reach disk of point P with respect to this one? We have defined it. So that is reach disk of a point P1 with respect to O is nothing but the distance from point P to O or K disk, whichever is the maximum. So what will be the K disk of this point? K nearest neighbor distance will be this one, and then distance from this point to P will be much larger. So therefore, reach disk of this point will be the distance from point to P. Similarly, for this point, what will be the reach disk? So reach disk of point P with respect to this point, you have to first compute the point O. This is considering O, K disk or K distance, and then which one is maximum K disk of this point to this point, and then for this point again this O point. So therefore, average distance will be almost the radius of this big circle. Okay, so that will give you the average distance and divided by 3 points because it has 3 neighbors. Okay, once you do it, so that will give you the local reachability density. Inverse of that, it will give you the local reachability density. Now let's say any point here you want to compute the LRD. So then what you have to do? You have to compute the nearest neighbor of this point. Okay, you have to compute the nearest neighbor of this point. Once you compute the nearest neighbor, then each point, with respect to each point, you have to compute the reach disk. So reach disk of this point with respect to its neighbors will be the almost same as the distance from this point to this one. Okay, so therefore here the density will be almost same of neighbor points, but however here density will be different from the rest of the point. So here is the key point. Okay, so now where we had, so somewhere here, can you see the slide, old slide? I don't think you can see.
Yes sir.
Which one?
The PDF.
Green one.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
What is the page number? Page number is here. Can you see?
11.
11. Okay, you can see this one. 11. Okay, great. So then, local reachability density of an object P is defined as something 1/. So reach disk of P, as I said, and this one. So you will get the local reachability density of point. Now I am moving to the next slide. Now I am talking from the slide, not from the PDF, that paper. So now you define the LOF score. So now we are defining LOF score is something like that. So for point P, first what you have to do, you have to compute the k nearest neighbor. Okay. And after computing the k nearest neighbor, you compute the local reachability density of each point of the each nearest neighbor of the point P. So you compute the LRD and divide it by LRD of the point P. So this is the key term you need to understand. We already compute LRD of the each point. So now what you do it? Compute the LRD of the each point. Points are the neighbors of the point for which we want to find the LOF value, and then divide it by minimum number of points. Okay, so that will give you the local outlier factor. So highest LOF score objects are considered as outlier. Okay, so the value, as you understand in last example here, yeah, now I am talking about the paper LOF. Okay, page number 5 here. So the point is quite far away. So as you understand, for this point density will be quite low because reach distance is high and then 1/. So therefore, with respect to this one, if you take the average local reachability density of this point, this point, this point, that will be higher than the with this with respect to this point. So therefore, because it is higher numerator, so therefore this value will be more than this the points corresponding LRD. So therefore, value is higher indicates the LRD value, or LOA value is more indicate the point is outlier. Okay. So there are some drawbacks that some of the points mistreat and outlier points in a scenario where the sparse cluster is close to a dense cluster. If two clusters, one is very sparse cluster, another is dense cluster, so then what may happen that, so this technique that it mistreat an outlier point in a scenario where the sparse cluster is close to a dense cluster, that means if there is a sparse cluster and dense cluster, so in that case these techniques cannot identify the outlier in the right way. Okay, so now we'll talk about another techniques and then we'll come back to LOF again, okay, to address this issue. Or otherwise, what I can do it, I can go back here, okay, here. So this is the problem. This work came into 2006 from the same group of people here. That is something called symmetric neighborhood overcome the shortcoming of LOF. Problem here, if you see this point Q, okay. So if you find the outlier of a point Q, so it will be treated as a outlier really, okay. Now, if you see the point P, okay, so point P also will be treated as a outlier by LOF technique, okay. But point P is a cluster point which is quite sparse with respect to the cluster C1. So there are two clusters, one is C1, another is C2, okay. And these are the outlier that can be detected by LOF technique. Okay, so as you can see from the left side figure, okay, I am talking on the slide number 15. So here what you can see that Q is really outlier point, so it can be detected by LOF technique. But P is a cluster point, but unfortunately LOF will treat P as the outlier point. What happened is here density of this region and density of this region varies, and therefore P will be treated as outlier point with respect to this cluster C1. So to overcome this one, so another technique is introduced is called the symmetric neighborhood technique, where symmetric neighborhood techniques, they define the outlier factor is something called inflow X, they define with this term. What is that? Average density of a set of points divided by the density of the point X. That is, we are doing earlier also, we did it. Average density of the its neighbors divided by the density of the point. So if you go back the LOF definition, if you don't forget here LOF definition, what we are taking the average density here also, we are taking the average, okay, because this n by n is there, so we are taking the LORD, so here, and then you are taking average. So if you take it here, so this is also quite similar, this is also quite average, like we are taking here and then divided by n. So here, so what is the great thing from the earlier work to here? Earlier work, whatever they are taking in LOF, all they are taking for the k nearest neighbor of the concern point, let's say P points, okay. So P points k nearest neighbor, if you see the distance, P points k nearest neighbor will include these three points here, okay, and none of the point from the same clusters, and the density of these points and density of this point varies heavily. So therefore this point will be treated as the outlier. How? Please try to understand this part, okay. Here, see here, if you see the k nearest neighbor of P, it will include this point and this point. So how do you compute the LOF? In order to compute the LOF, you have to compute the k nearest neighbor of this point, so you got this point. Now what you have to do, you have to compute LRD of this point. So LRD of this point means what? It's k nearest neighbor. So its nearest neighbor will be coming from here and then distance from here. So therefore it will influence this density. So therefore this point will be considered with respect to this heavily dense point. So therefore P will be treated as outlier, but actually P is in layer, it belongs to different clusters. So that will not be captured by LOF. So what they did in symmetric neighborhood, instead of considering only the k nearest neighbor of the point P, so they consider, you consider the k nearest neighbor as well as you consider the reverse k nearest neighbor of the point P. And then you take the average density of the all points. So IS is nothing but the influential space of P. So influential space of X here in this case, or in this case P, consists of the point from the k nearest neighbor as well as the reverse k nearest neighbor. So now in order to understand this one, we should understand what is reverse k nearest neighbor. Here we go. So the reverse k nearest neighbor is defined as reverse KNN of a point P is a set of point P where P is a nearest neighbor of point Q. So RNN of a point P is a set of point Q where P is considered as the k nearest neighbor of P. So let's say we have a data set here, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5 and P1 a point. And what you do is you compute the k nearest neighbor of the all points. So let's say k nearest neighbor of point is P, Q2, Q4. K nearest neighbor of Q2 equal to P. Most probably I also told what is reverse k nearest neighbor in NBC algorithm, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you know what is reverse k nearest neighbor. Okay, let me explain here. Let's say k nearest neighbor of Q1, you got this one. K nearest neighbor of Q2, you got this one. K nearest neighbor of Q3, you got, and k nearest neighbor of Q4, you got. So now what you have to do, you have to compute the reverse k nearest neighbor of P. For that, what we'll see? We'll see whether P has been included as nearest neighbor of the any point. So P is included as one nearest neighbor by Q1, P is included as nearest neighbor by Q2, P included nearest neighbor of the point Q4. So therefore, reverse k nearest neighbor of P will be Q1, Q2, Q4. So Q1, Q2, Q4. Okay. So now, in order to compute the influence space, you take this set of points along the P nearest neighbor of P. Okay. So therefore, here. So now what happened? It is, so what will be the nearest neighbor of P? So obviously this point will be the nearest neighbor of P. And now you see the reverse k nearest neighbor of P. Reverse k nearest neighbor of P, no point will consider this point is the nearest neighbor from this set of points. Because if you consider the k nearest neighbor of this point, exactly this point, so it will take only from this point, this region. So P will not be included. So therefore, who will include P? These set of points will include P. So now you got the point of influence space, not only from the points here, you get also point from here. Now in order to compute the density or average density, you have to compute the density of this region as well as you have to compute density of this parts region. So you take some average value and that will balance key that inflow value and then divided by density of this point will be this one. So it will be very close to 1. So therefore this point won't be treated as a outlier. So that is the main idea of this symmetric neighborhood algorithm. Okay. So in 2009, now we'll go another work. So paper published in PAKDD. So that is another good conference. They said ki LOF is good, but problem with LOF is it cannot identify the outlier in a sparse region. So if the data, so let's say you are identifying some star in the galaxy, whether that is a quite different from the rest of the thing, because in galaxy, as you know, that stars are quite far away, so therefore the data will not be very dense. So this is a sparse region, this is also a sparse region, so this is also a sparse region. In this scenario, actually finding outlier using LOF is quite troublesome. Therefore, they introduced, Zhang introduced a clustering algorithm is called the LOF, local density based outlier factor. So here they also compute the same thing, that is the value of LDOF, that is outlierness of a point, is defined by two parameter. One is smaller d, another is capital D. Now we'll talk about what is these two and take the ratio of these two. So here, as I said, this is smaller d and capital D. What is that smaller d here? DXP is the distance from the point XP to the all its neighbor. That is average neighbor distance is something called, they are saying the smaller d. Say in this example, there is no point here, only this set of points. So XP is a point. So you are finding the k nearest neighbor. So k nearest neighbor, you got this point, this all set of points, you find the k nearest neighbor. Okay. Now what you do, you take the average k nearest neighbor distance. So distance from XP to the all points. Okay. You take that. So that is something called smaller d. So if you take the distance, so here to here, this is here to here and here and so. So if you take the average, so we are assuming average will be something like that. Okay. So average distance from here to here, here to here, here to here, all distances. Okay. K nearest neighbor point. Now another is capital D. What is capital D? Capital D is something like that. You exclude this point. Earlier what you are doing, we are computing distance from the given point to the all its neighbor. Now it you exclude this point. So now if you exclude this point, you will have left with this set of points, and you compute the average distances. So if you compute the average distances, so that will give you the density of k nearest neighbor excluding the point here. So that is here, dx bar will be the average distances from all its points. Okay. So now if you take, so let's say earlier you had all the distances from XP. So therefore you will get the bigger circle. Now if you exclude this one, so you have to compute the all points here. Okay. Here. So we are considering that one is, that will be close to inner circle, this radius. Now what you do, you take the ratio of the smaller d and capital D. Obviously, if the point is outlier, this value will be much higher with respect to the point this one, so therefore it will be treated as the outlier. Now if you see the points within a cluster point, so therefore cluster point means all points are very close to each other. If you exclude this point, this value and this value also will be close to each other, so therefore that value will be close to 1. So therefore if LDO value is quite far away from the from 1, so then that point will be the outlier. However, the point is quite close to 1 will be treated as an inlier point. So it is convincing. Is it convincing? Okay. So I am done. So if you have a question from today's class, please raise your hand or you ask directly.
Sir?
Yes.
So here in this current slide, density of X is the, what is density of X?
Current slide means?
So symmetric neighborhood approach.
X or XP?
No, so not here, symmetric neighborhood approach.
Symmetric neighborhood.
Here. So the numerator is the average density of its influential space, which means k nearest neighbors and also reverse k nearest neighbors. But what is density X, the denominator?
Now here also you should have same question, how do you define density here? See here, this is nothing but the set of points, okay, and then average you are taking, average of those set of each point you have to compute the density. So density is actually number of points within the, see density here you can compute the KDs divided by the number of points, so that is the average distance, okay, average k nearest neighbor distance.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So then tomorrow we can fix exam at 10:30, or do you have any other exam?
So 10:30 is fine.
Someone said it's second half you had some trouble, someone said, right? So 10:30 is okay?
Or at 11 PM also test.
Yes, sir. 10:30 is fine.
Sir, at 10:30 we have ACA Advanced Computer Architecture class, and they can take the test because it's last class.
What is Advanced Computer Architecture? Turuk sir.
Yes, sir. Ashok Kumar Turuk sir.
Sure. So then
11.
He has class from
10
to 11, right?
Huh? So from 11 we have advanced software engineering class, and he will also take a test.
So then at what time you want to be? 8 to 9 only?
Yes sir, 8 to 9.
12.
Huh? Sir, we are free at your regular
sir, then
class
we can
time
do it
from 8
10.
To 9.
No, 10 to 11 there is a class, Advanced Computer Architecture class.
So then 12.
Any
so on Fridays for CSE, we have classes from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m.
8 a.m. to 2 p.m.
Sir, 8 yes, to 9 is your class. Next is image processing. Then we have advanced computer that
no, architecture. Is teachers are taking classes tomorrow again? That is my
yes, question. Sir. There is test for I think all the classes like IP and that computer architecture, then software engineering. All have test tomorrow.
Okay. Or you want to do, give test on Saturday?
Sir,
sure,
you can
sir.
Take it at morning time 8 to 9.
Sir, Saturday would be good.
Yes, sir, Saturday.
I'll be outstation actually, like it's
sir, on Saturday.
It's available.
Outstation, but it will be connected, no?
No, sir, I will be injured.
Like, I'll be like, it might be not internet connection there.
So you can take test at your regular from 8 to 9.
Huh?
Sir, tomorrow you have class from 8 to 9, right? You can take test at that time.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I have to make question now. That is, I am seeking some time. Anyway, so then I will try to do it.
Sir, then evening time, no one will be have class.
No, someone is traveling.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sir, after 2:30 we are